Microsoft has made a lot of features available for new stream built on SharePoint. The most recent is SharePoint Video Collections Pages. The one small problem that I found with the announcement was that the way to use the new video layout was not super clear in the announcement. So let's look at it together. The first thing you need to do is go to the SharePoint site where you want to add your video collection. In the URL, you're going to copy and paste an extra string for the layout that's associated with the video collection. I've included this in the description below the video to make it easy for you to find. SharePoint is going to generate you a videos collection page, but you're not done. At this point in time, nobody can see the page except for you. What you need to do is go to the right-hand side of the screen and select the Edit button. And then all you have to do is click Publish, but let me add a few pieces of information here, because what SharePoint has actually done is it's created a highlighted content web part on a SharePoint page for you. You may notice that there are no videos on my SharePoint page, and you might wonder why that is. Well, the reason is SharePoint is taking its best guess as to where you might be keeping your videos. So when I click on Edit the Web Part, I can see where SharePoint is looking. In the source, it says a document library on this site. In the document library, it chose the very first library on my site, which is Activity Report. If you use the default document library that's generically called Document Library, that's what will be in this field. However, I use multiple document libraries to organize my content. My hint to you is to create a video document library to make it easy for everyone to know exactly where they should put their videos in order for them to feed to the video collections library. And now you can see the sample videos are loading on the page. By default, SharePoint is just looking for the most recent videos. If you're happy with the basic page, it's time to go ahead and publish it so everyone who has access to this SharePoint site can see your video collections page. You have a few options here on how you want to share your videos with people. What I prefer to do is add the page to navigation. What this does is you may notice that a video link popped up in the header of my website. Now the average user who comes to the information homepage can click on videos to scroll through and see all of the videos that I have added. The next thing I want to show you is how to mimic playlists like we had on Classic Stream. I know where I work, we're a big fan of that. I've put the web page into edit mode, and I'm going to add a new highlighted content web part. I'm going to select a document library on this site, and I'm going to select video again, and make sure that we're only looking for the video file type. Then I'm going to click the drop-down for filter and search for a column name. The easiest way I found to do this is select name for file. Then I'm going to select contains and enter my search term. So my first playlist is going to be about teams, so that is going to be my search term. By default, SharePoint wants to show you up to 8 videos at a time, but you can always change this number if you have more videos that you would like to share in the playlist. Now I'm going to quickly go through and use the exact same steps so that we can have another playlist for forms. I only have a few sample videos, but you can keep repeating this process until you have as many categories as you need. When you're done, go to the upper right-hand corner and click Republish. Now the visitors to your website can see the most recent videos at the top, then they can see my Teams playlist, and then they can see the Forms playlist. This is just some basic customization for your SharePoint video collection. You can do other things like adding thumbnails to the videos, which I've shown in a different video that you can see linked here on the screen. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.